Hey, looking for a car truck? Search the AutoChannel.com's actual price paid guide to quickly and easily find 100% accurate used car values. Don't get the blues, get smart, not screwed. The AutoChannel.com, there's nothing else like it.
Your friendly Hawaii Volkswagen dealers present Ohana Road, Hawaii's automotive TV magazine. Featuring all the latest and greatest cars, trucks, vans, and SUVs coming your way. A visit with celebrity car enthusiasts. A look at fabulous classics and cars of tomorrow. Meet local stars and cars. All that and a bunch of Maloney. Right here on Ohana Road. With your hosts, Dale Payson and Anita Hall.
Aloha, everyone, and welcome once again to Hawaii's homegrown car show, Ohana Road. I'm Dale Payson, and on this week's show, it's all about the famous brand from Germany, Volkswagen. Anita Hall and I will shine the new car spotlight on some of VW's most popular models. Then on Car Mania, we take you back a few years to Volkswagen's very first foray into racing in the U.S., an open-wheel racing program called Formula V. On Concepts and Classics, we'll move from the past into the future as we see how a Volkswagen Touareg SUV won a government-sponsored program to develop a driverless car. And on Hawaii Stars and Cars, our favorite Hawaii funny man, Pee-Pee, gets nostalgic about the now-closed track at Hawaii Raceway Park. All that plus a bunch of Maloney. So put your feet up and let us do the driving. Tonight's edition of Ohana Road starts right after this.
Thanks to the VW Sign, Then Drive event, just about any fun-loving Volkswagen person can get into one. Just sign, then drive.
It's hot in here.
It's warm. I'm a little warm, too. Your keys?
No down payment, no first month's payment, zero due at signing. Now until January 31st.
I'm Bobby Likas, and I've discovered a fountain of youth for cars. One reason our cars get old before their time is the same thing that keeps them going, fuel. The carbon deposits left by fuel burned in your engine can choke off its air and fuel mixture, reducing efficiency. The BG Fuel Service removes harmful carbon buildup, dramatically improves power and mileage, and includes BG 44K to treat the entire fuel system.
44K is great. BG.
Hey, you ready yet?
Dude, I forgot my towel.
Don't worry. I got my assets covered. Dude,
I'm sorry.
Weta Kolay seat covers. It's like having a wetsuit for your seats. They're waterproof, snagproof, and stainproof. Ask for the original by name, Weta Kolay.
In past editions of Ohana Road, we've told you how the ugly duckling Volkswagen Beetle was first brought to this country in the late 1950s, and how through some clever advertising, it became a huge sales success. Today, Volkswagen is one of the largest auto manufacturers on the planet with over 350,000 employees worldwide. The VW line has also gone from just one lowly bug to now a full line of sports cars, sedans, and SUVs. And to show off that line, we begin with a lovable new Beetle convertible.
Inspired by a classic from the past, the new Volkswagen Beetle convertible puts the fun back into driving. Incorporating the style and design that has traditionally made this a great car, the Beetle comes with a host of new amenities. In addition to the car's classic arched appearance, the new bug has body-colored bumpers, plastic front and rear fenders, and dual-tone horns. The new Beetle convertible is a two-door, four-passenger car available in several trims and engine choices, from a 115-horsepower 2-liter engine all the way up to Volkswagen's 1.8T turbocharged power plant, putting out 180 horsepower. Other features include air conditioning, an anti-theft alarm system, automatic locks, self-dimming rearview mirror, an 80-watt 10-speaker sound system, and an automatic top that opens or closes in just 13 seconds. Like the original Beetle convertibles of the 50s, 60s, and 70s, designers were able to keep its familiar profile while giving the old classic a fresh look.
Not that long ago, SUVs became one of the most popular automotive segments in America, and Volkswagen developed a model to compete with the best of them. Built alongside its cousin, the Porsche Cayenne, let's head to Aloha Tower Marketplace, where Anita will give us a close-up look at the Volkswagen Touareg. Anita?
The popular and very rugged Touareg, a true luxury sport utility, gets a new look for 2008. Motor Trend says the Volkswagen SUV is going to avoid the fate of other SUVs in the changing market by refining this fifth-year model with new and improved features worth mentioning. Touareg 2 made an impressive debut in the action flick Bourne Ultimatum. Professional stunt car driver Greg Tracy was, in his words, blown away at how much of a beating the Touareg took in the New York City crash-em-up car chase scene. And fellow stunt car driver Scott Rogers said this is a vehicle he'd put his wife and kids in every day. Why not? With the highest government impact rating, safe happens.
The Volkswagen Touareg sets the standard for luxury in an SUV. Built with classy, elegant lines, the Touareg delivers a smooth and comfortable ride on the highway. These luxury characteristics are obvious at first glance. Stylish body design with the craftsmanship of wood and leather. The result is a unique combination of features in a luxurious, high-performance SUV with everyday practicality without restrictions. Touareg is the Volkswagen way to say modern luxury station wagon. It's a V8 or V6 powered vehicle with 310 or 220 horses and a V10 turbo diesel. And it's filled with top luxury. A strongly designed profile, a rugged stance, and a stylishly smooth, characteristic VW front end, one good-looking SUV. It resembles its sister platform-sharing Porsche Cayenne. Ruggedness and luxury in one neat package, the Volkswagen Touareg.
So there you have it, Touareg, a boulevard cruiser that can take on the Rubicon Trail rock by rock. Check it out online at Volkswagen.com and then visit your local Volkswagen dealer and be impressed in person. Dale?
Thanks, Anita. Not long ago, the U.S. government sponsored a serious competition challenging the world's automakers to build a driverless vehicle that could navigate a preset course in the high desert of Nevada for use in the battlefields of the future. With a $1 million prize at stake, the competition was stiff, and you'll never guess who won. It's this week's installment of Concepts and Classics.
The United States military is looking for technology that will transform the face of the battlefield of the future. And for obvious reasons, they want military vehicles to be driverless. So in 2004, the federal government inaugurated the Defense Advanced Research Projects Agency, or DARPA, Grand Challenge. 195 universities and high technology companies from 36 states and 4 foreign countries responded with a plethora of robotic cars, trucks, SUVs, and even a motorcycle. The mission was to leverage research and ingenuity to develop transformational technologies that will give our armed forces an added edge. DARPA offered a $2 million prize to the vehicle that could navigate the 141-mile simulated battlefield in the Nevada desert and come home first with no one at the wheel. Some 5,000 people attended, scientists, technicians, race teams, and the media, along with hundreds of geeks, were all there to see who would win the $2 million purse. Stanford University was the team behind Stanley, a Volkswagen Touareg. Carnegie Mellon University had the pole with their big Highlander. Though extremely slow and nerve-wracking, Stanley took control of the race from its main competitor, the Highlander. It was interesting to note that Highlander was also backed by two famous Stanford alums, the guys who founded Google. At the end, Stanley the Touareg, with its drive-by-wire technology, proved superior and won the event in 6 hours, 5 minutes, at an average speed of 19.1 miles per hour. Its huge race team of Stanford students, engineers, VW execs, and general techies all celebrated by hoisting a can of Red Bull as their victory toast. Here's hoping that cutting-edge technology will create safer combat conditions for our troops of tomorrow.
Stay tuned, we'll be right back. right back.
Thanks to the VW Sign, Then Drive event, just about any fun-loving Volkswagen person can get into one. Just sign, then drive.
It's hot in here.
It's warm. I'm a little warm, too. Your keys?
No down payment, no first month's payment, zero due at signing. Now until January 31st.
No matter what kind of car or truck you drive, Redline Automotive offers quality parts to fit any domestic or import vehicle. From General Motors, Ford, and Chrysler, to Honda, Toyota, and Mitsubishi, let our friendly, experienced staff help you find just what you're looking for. Redline Automotive offers AC Delco batteries with the best battery warranty in the industry. Come check us out. There are three locations to serve you. Redline Automotive, Hawaii's exclusive AC Delco distributor.
Hi, I'm Leah. You know, you can search the AutoChannel.com's new car buyer's guide to quickly and easily find specs, prices, multi-car comparison, and the latest news about every new passenger car and truck sold in North America. The AutoChannel.com, there's nothing else like it.
At Bank of Hawaii, we not only see who you are today, but who you want to be tomorrow. It starts by understanding your hopes and your dreams for the future. Whether that means growing a business or having more time to watch your kids grow, retiring to explore the world, or being able to retire to the backyard oasis you've always wanted. At Bank of Hawaii, our goal is to help dreams come true and have people say, "That's my bank."
Back some years ago, after the initial success of the now iconic little VW Beetle, Volkswagen wanted to show America that their cars were not just little putt-putts. And what better way for a manufacturer to do that than to enter the world of auto racing? In the glory days of crazy sprint cars and midget racers, NASCAR stockers and big-budget IndyCar teams, Volkswagen developed a racing series for the everyday man called Formula V. We thought you'd like to see how it all got started. Brought to you by Weto Coley, here's this week's Car Mania.
Although the Volkswagen Beetle enjoys a worldwide distinction as one of history's most resilient and remarkable automobiles, it's pretty tough to picture it as the basis for a genuine high-performance race machine. But in 1963, that's exactly what happened when the Sports Car Club of America created the Formula V class, open-wheel, rear-engine race cars with mechanicals provided mostly by the Volkswagen Beetle. Formula V immediately became wildly popular as a strictly amateur class that featured terrific levels of competitiveness within the budgets of just about anyone who wanted to give it a shot. In 1991, Pro V took the Formula V idea to the next logical step by bringing major sponsorship on board while retaining the purity and simplicity of the class, meaning...
Well, what it is a bunch of Formula V drivers from the SCCA, Sports Car Club of America, who organized a series with a major sponsorship from Valvoline and now from ADPAC Corporation as well. And we run races with stock SCCA Formula Vs and we get paid for it.
If you had to describe the overwhelming attitude found at a typical Pro V event, the term infectious enthusiasm comes quickly to mind. Everyone has their own favorite driving force behind why they love it.
I like the open wheel cars. They're a lot more fun for me anyway. I just like the type of formula. I like the ability to work on the car myself, to be able to find parts readily available for this car if something does happen. It's just mechanically, it's an easy class to work on.
Great wheel-to-wheel competition, low cost, and a community spirit have all helped to make Pro V an enormously popular series. This event on the high banks of Charlotte sure looked like fun. You can almost imagine what a kick it is to dice, dart, and dive around an exciting track like this and well-balanced race car. And how close was the finish?
One of us won.
Yeah.
Depending on who you talk to.
6 inches. Whoever won, they won by 6 inches.
As I mentioned earlier, one of the craziest forms of motorsports is something called sprint car racing. And you may not know it, but before it closed, Hawaii had a quarter-mile dirt track of its own out at the Campbell facility, and it was called Hawaii Motor Speedway. Let's join our resident kukui nut, Pee-Pee, as he takes us on a nostalgic look back at Hawaii sprint cars on tonight's Hawaii Stars and Cars.
Hawaii Stars and Cars, brought to you by the Honolulu Advertiser, Hawaii's newspaper. Find your next great deal on wheels in the Advertiser's Hawaii's Cars section.
Connecting, it's what we do, with local stories that take you there as life unfolds. The Honolulu Advertiser is here for you, 24 hours a day, with nearly 900 dedicated employees, bringing you the stories you want and the values you need. We're here to keep that bond. The Honolulu Advertiser, Hawaii's newspaper. Shift into overdrive and find the ride of your life every Sunday in Hawaii's Cars. It's the best and brightest auto section around, now in the Sunday Honolulu Advertiser.
To think that the Hawaii Racer Park will soon be no more. I mean, this is crazy. I'm like standing beside myself going, you know, here we are, and it's going to be gone soon. This is crazy, man. Hey, much mahalo to all you brothers and sisters that keep the sport going. Look at that. Wow. Cool. What's up, man? I'm over here with Paul from Kaneohe, and Paul looks like, wow, a lot better dressed than I am. And you look like you're ready for some action, Paul.
Oh, yes, I am.
This is on dragster with the motor in the front. This is something's wrong over here.
Yeah, it's a front motor dragster.
What year?
No, it was made in the mid-60s.
When's the last time you didn't ride this bugger?
End of last year. But prior to that, I haven't ran the car for like 18 to 20 years.
Tonight, we're bringing them out, man. We get the trailer, we get the crew. You ready for have some fun? We're going to try to throw them on a track tonight, maybe? We can twist your arm?
We will, right away, right after you.
All right. Now, the reason why they actually took the motor and they put him in the back is because these motors in the front kept blowing up, okay? So this guy is a stunt master. Don't try this at home. Only from professionals from Kaneohe. Name what?
Paul Nakasone.
That's right, Paul Nakasone. Remember that name. All right. Per gallon. Oh my gosh, you must be rich, Earl.
Not really. All my unemployment is here.
There you go. Hey, Earl from Waipao, thanks for joining us here. The nostalgic Hawaii Raceway Park races over here. And will you be racing on Nimitz or Dillingham when the park closes?
None.
Okay, good.
Thanks, Pee-Pee. If you've just joined us, we're shining the new car spotlight on the latest models from famous German automaker Volkswagen. And if you're young, or just young at heart, here's a car that spells fun in capital letters. It's low, it's sleek, it's got a 200-horsepower turbocharged engine under the hood. It's the new Volkswagen GTI.
The new Volkswagen GTI is a two-door hatchback sport coupe with seating for five passengers. The new GTI has more power with a turbocharged 2-liter four-cylinder engine putting out 200 horsepower. There are two transmission choices, a standard 6-speed manual or optional 6-speed automatic with steering wheel mounted paddle shifting. But you don't have to give up great fuel mileage for performance. The new GTI is rated at 24 miles per gallon city and 31 miles per gallon highway. A sports-tuned suspension gives the car tight handling with McPherson struts up front and a multi-link setup in back. Front and rear stabilizers are standard, as are four-wheel ABS disc brakes for quick and safe stopping. Speaking of safety, the new GTI comes standard with dual front, side, and side curtain airbags, three-point lap and shoulder belts, and electronic stability control. The all-new Volkswagen GTI.
Now, if comfort and space for the whole family is more your speed, here's Anita standing by at Aloha Tower Marketplace with the flagship of the Volkswagen fleet, the new VW Passat. Anita?
Dale, you know I'm a little biased when it comes to the VW nameplate, as I'm the happy owner of a Passat. In addition to loving everything about this car, from its sleek styling to its responsiveness, safety is always number one in my book, especially with my sons getting their driver's licenses this year. Yes, licenses! The Volkswagen Passat is the German automaker's style leader, their top-selling family sedan. You know the one with distinctive European panache?
The 2008 Volkswagen Passat is a mid-size car available as a 5-passenger sedan or station wagon. Both body styles are available in 4 trims: Turbo, Comfort, Lux, and VR6. Turbo, Comfort, and Lux trim Passats are powered by Volkswagen's 200 horsepower 2-liter turbocharged 4-cylinder engine, mated to either a 6-speed manual or a 6-speed automatic transmission. The VR6 model adds a 280 horse 6-cylinder engine with a 6-speed automatic. A fully independent suspension, along with a rigid structure, provides sportier handling than previous Passat generations. In turbo trim, the new Passat comes standard with 16-inch alloy wheels, full power accessories including a power driver's seat, and a CD stereo system. Comfort trim adds 17-inch wheels, a sunroof, and an in-dash CD changer, while Lux trim includes luxury upholstery, dual-zone climate control, and front and rear parking sensors. A family sedan that's fun to drive, the new Volkswagen Passat.
With 32 miles per gallon highway, Passat is the right car for my fuel-weary pocketbook. The folks at Volkswagen invite you to schedule your very own joyride. Dale?
Thank you, Anita. Is it true you could steal a Honda Civic with a butter knife? Well, Bill's got the answer coming up next on A Bunch of Maloney.
Thanks to the VW Sign, Then Drive event, just about any fun-loving Volkswagen person can get into one. Just sign, then drive.
Hot in here.
It's warm. I'm a little warm too. Your keys?
No down payment, no first month's payment, zero due at signing. Now until January 31st.
One of the biggest property crimes in America and Hawaii is stolen cars. But which brands are most likely to be stolen? Our old friend Bill has been doing some research on the subject, and he has the answers for you. In fact, here he is now with A Bunch of Maloney.
In the car theft world, they probably say you are what you steal, and it varies state by state. And the winners are Acura, Toyota, Ford, and Oldsmobile. Every year, the National Highway Transportation Safety Bureau issues a rundown of the most stolen cars in the U.S., also state-by-state statistics. I thought it'd be interesting to see just what the bad guys are stealing and then try to figure out why. You'd think the top targets would be Porsche, Corvette, Cadillac, Lincoln, Mercedes. Go in style, pimp my ride. Well, we're in for a few surprises. The most stolen car nationally is the 1999 Acura, and locally, the 89 Toyota Camry. Get that? 89, not the new Camry. The reason, we're told, is because it's not only the easiest car to heist, but the parts are usable, saleable, and in demand. On a state-by-state basis, there's some interesting developments. Now, in Alabama, the number one target is the Chevrolet full-size pickup. They probably steal it for the gun in the rack behind the driver, the rear window, right next to the Confederate flag. In Colorado, thieves like the Dodge Colt. It figures Colorado, Cowboys, Colts. Hondas of all kinds are popular with crooks. That's because in a lot of cases, any old key will fit the ignition. Some older models, Honda is the car of choice in Pennsylvania, Nevada, Maryland, New Jersey, Utah, and South Carolina. Obviously, street racing is popular everywhere. On a serious note, Lieutenant O'Bigris says, car thievery is down in our fair city because the public is more aware of theft problems, better auto prevention hardware, and our new cars and new alarm systems on the market. The cops in the traffic division may say, click it or ticket, but the auto theft detail of HPD says, lock it or lose it. I'm Bill Maloney. I'm going to go outside and see if my car's still there.
That's a wrap for this week's edition of Ohana Road. We're glad you came along. Remember, Ohana Road airs twice a week, Saturday nights at 6 and Sunday nights at 11, plus a Friday preview on KITV4's morning show. For the latest show info, be sure to check out the Ohana Road page every Friday in the Honolulu Advertisers TGIF section. You can now watch past episodes of Ohana Road right on your computer by surfing over to www.theautochannel.com and clicking on the Ohana Road logo. And for more about your favorite Ohana Road personalities, just log on to ohanaroad.net. That's .net. On the next Ohana Road, on Car Mania, we'll go back in time to the early days to watch the very first commercials for a brand new car called the Ford Mustang. Then on Concepts and Classics is a visit with a true automotive legend as Barry McGuire talks with Carol Shelby. Then it's back home to the islands as our own Kukui nut, Pee-Pee, has a little fun with some local Ford lovers. All that plus a bunch of Maloney. Hope you'll join us. Until then, from the Pacific Aviation Museum, I'm Dale Payson. Mahalo, everybody.
You can catch Ohana Road twice a week, Saturday nights at 6 and Sunday nights at 11 on KITV4. Catering by Hooters Restaurant. Dale Payson's Aloha shirts provided by Mamo Howell. Anita Hall's wardrobe courtesy of Cache. Special thanks to GO, Hawaii's low-cost airline and the official airline of Ohana Road. Brought to you by your friendly Hawaii Volkswagen dealers.
Hey, cool video, huh? Now's a good time to search the autochannel.com's buyer's guides to quickly and easily find the most in-depth news, specs, prices, rebates, crash ratings, and recalls for every brand of vehicle sold in North America. TheAutoChannel.com. There's nothing else like it.